Using rally test cases for acceptance testing. A test case is a guideline for confirming that a piece of functionality, defined in the acceptance criteria of a user story or defect, works according to expectations. In Rally, each user story or defect may have one or more test cases that you can use to ensure proper functionality for the work item. We call these functional tests or acceptance tests, and you can use these to manually check an operation. When testing a user story or defect, it's easy to create a test case directly from the work item. This saves you time and helps you to track the testing efforts in the acceptance criteria or the definition of done for the work item. You'll need to have editor permissions for your project to create or associate test cases with work items. Let's add a test case to one of the stories or defects in our iteration. First, go to the Work Item Detail page and expand it to Full View. Then select the Test Cases icon at the top of the page. If you have existing test cases that you've already created, you can use the Link Existing function. You can create standalone test cases as part of test planning, which will be discussed in a later video. Select the Add New button to add a new test case to validate the billing and shipping addresses against the United States Postal Service database, as specified in the acceptance criteria. First, we'll give it a name that indicates the validation we're doing. Then, choose the type and method of the test. In this case, we're doing a manual acceptance test for the address validation acceptance criteria. Select Create to add a placeholder test case, or Create with Details to finish defining the test case. As you can see, the story's description field has been conveniently copied to the description for the test case. We can constrain it to focus on the acceptance criteria for this test case. Scrolling down, we can add any notes to the test case like we can with other work items, and we can specify the objective. In this case, to validate the billing and shipping addresses and indicate errors. Here we can specify the preconditions for the test case, what state or situations we'll be in as we begin testing. For example, logged in as a specific user, at least one item in the shopping cart, at checkout, and ready to check out. Next, we can add the validation input. For this example, we'll specify that we'll enter invalid address information, and we'll select the Submit button whenever we want to send the address to the system. The validation expected results should say what we expect to happen when we validate this condition. Here, we'll expect to get an error saying that the address is invalid. Post conditions specify the state or situation of the system after you've entered the validation input. After entering an invalid address, we expect to remain on the address form with the error message specified and the address field box border highlighted in red. Nothing else should have changed on the form. We will see in a minute that the conditions and validation information are reported in the steps for this test case. Other details, such as the test folder, which is created as part of the test planning process, whether or not the test is expedited, and other descriptors, such as tags, level of risk, milestones, priority, and attachments, can all be specified from the detail page for the test case. We'll create this test case now and continue to explore how to use it. For this test case, we can create defects based on our findings by selecting the defects icon. We can link this test case to an existing test set. We will talk more about test sets when we talk about regression testing in another video. As we use this test case, you may view results and test run details by selecting these icons. As with other work items, you can add discussions about what you encounter as you do this work, view the revision history, and see details about connections to third-party integrations. For this test case, we have two steps. Select Add New to add each one. For the first step, add an invalid address. The expected result for this step is only that the typed address shows in the form. For the second step, select the Submit button. The expected result is to see an error message and indication and remain on the address form. Now we're ready to execute this test case. To record the results for the test case, execute the steps and select the results icon. As you can see, you can add a result or a defect directly from the results summary. Select Add Result and indicate the number of the build you are testing. Next, indicate your last verdict and any notes you may want to add. Add any attachments of screenshots, for example, and in the duration field, type the number of minutes that it took to execute the test case. This is useful for test planning. Select Create, then select the X at the top right of the page to return to the test case. A test run is a view of one or more test cases and their status listed in a single, summarized display. Access the test run page from the detail editor of applicable work items, in this example, the test case. If you select the test run icon, you will see details of the test case and the status of the test. The inline icons to the right of the test case make it convenient for you to add a new test result, add a defect, or edit the test case from the test run summary. Let's go back to the user story and select the test run icon from this perspective. Here, you can view the status of each test case associated with the user story. You can filter the type of tests, the methods, and the last verdict from the toolbar. Choose your option and select Filter to update your view. You may add another test case right from this view by selecting New Test Case from the Actions menu. When a test case is added to a user story, it is also added to the test run. At the top right of the test run page, you'll see a summary of the percentage of passing tests and the percentage of trialed user stories, if any, that have test cases. If you hover over the passing percentage, you will see the test cases that failed. You can do the same for percentage covered to see any trialed stories without test cases. Congratulations! Now you understand how to use test cases to validate and accept user stories and defects. Next, discover how Rally can help you manage regression testing using test cases and test sets. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. Like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you'll never miss new content as it's added.